Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Diego Ortiz from the American Heart Association, and I am excited to welcome you to Creating Heart Safe Schools for Westchester County. Thank you for joining. This is a timely presentation and conversation for a few reasons. First, it's always a good time to learn the life-saving skill that is CPR. And second, because June 1st through 7th is National CPR and AED Awareness Week, a week dedicated to spotlighting how lives can be saved if more Americans know CPR and how to use an AED. And why is this important? Well, as you're going to learn in more detail in a few minutes, each year, about 350,000 out-of-hospital cardiac arrests occur in the United States. They take place at home, in the office, on the ball field, and in school. And what we know is that when a person has cardiac arrest, survival depends on immediately receiving CPR from someone nearby, as well as having access to an AED. If you're called on to give CPR in an emergency, you will most likely be trying to save the life of someone you love and know, likely a child, a spouse, a parent, or a close friend. And that's why we're here today. But before we get started, I want to encourage all of you to participate in today's conversation by interacting with our chat box. Throughout the conversation, you will see hyperlinks to additional resources. We also invite you to please type your questions in the chat box, and our guest speakers will do their best to answer your questions towards the end of the presentation. And now it is my pleasure to welcome Dr. Krista Miliarisis, Dana Colasante, and Alice Schoen. Welcome.
It was a Friday night at a gym in Grafton. Adam was playing in a away game for his high school basketball team. I was in the stands watching him play. He was very athletic. He loved his sports. During a break in the game, he just wasn't very stable with the way he was walking, and he took maybe one or two steps, and then he just collapsed. I absolutely had no clue what was happening. You know, this couldn't be happening to him. He was just so athletic, just appeared so healthy. What we learned since then was that he could have had a chance. There's about a 2 to 3 minute window that you need to have an AED applied and a shock given. The time it took for me to say, somebody call 911. So think about that in seconds, knowing that we're trying to do this within 2 minutes. It was just too late. I can still see the monitor in front of me with the straight line coming through and the reality of what I was looking at. That night is something I wake up with, live with, go through every day with. It'll never be outside of who I am and what I see. Adam's life couldn't end at the funeral. It needed to be carried on. And there was an obvious path. We needed to create something to say somebody has a cardiac arrest within those four walls, whether it's a teacher, a janitor, a parent, a grandparent, or a child. There's a rehearsed process to save that person's life. So that's what launched Project Adam. Needed somebody that has the ability, but also has the heart. Without Children's Hospital, without the Herman Heart Institute, this couldn't happen. I look at the extra work that they do. It's not in their job description. We get all that support from some of the brightest, smartest people I've ever encountered. It's a collective way that we work together that gets to the next step and the next step and the next step. Adam's still making a difference. There was a door that was opened that I never wanted to see, but it was open. It's the cards I was dealt, and I had to make a choice. And the choice was, I can't help my son, but I can help yours.
Hi, I'm Dana Colasante, part of the team that launched Project Adam in Westchester, New York. No matter how many times I watch that video, it makes me cry. It's so heartbreaking to know that a young person's death could have been prevented. And how powerful and inspiring are Adam's dad's words when he says, I can't help my son, but I can help yours. We launched Project Adam because we never want what happened to Adam to happen to any other child or person who walk the halls in our schools. Today we'll explain how you can prepare for a cardiac emergency in your school. Project Adam New York's Heart Safe School program is sponsored by Maria Freire Children's Hospital in Valhalla with the help of Saving Active Hearts and the American Heart Association. Our team includes Dr. Krista Mueller-Racis, a pediatric cardiologist at Maria Freire Children's Hospital, who is leading Project Adam as the medical director. Alice Schoen and myself, who started an initiative called Saving Active Hearts soon after my husband and her son both survived sudden cardiac arrest during youth athletic events. And Jennifer Miller, the executive director of the Westchester chapter of the American Heart Association, has been extremely supportive of our efforts to prevent sudden cardiac death from children in schools and youth sports. She introduced us to and helped us persuade Maria Freire Children's Hospital to become the first Project Adam affiliate in New York. And finally, we hope today's presentation will motivate you to join us and become a heart-safe school with the Project Adam program. Dr. Mueller-Racis is up next to explain what sudden cardiac arrest is, along with the causes and warning signs. And again, please stick around to the end of the presentation. We'll be happy to answer any questions you have.
Krista, you're on mute.
Thank you. Sudden cardiac arrest is the number one killer of Americans. Sudden cardiac arrest is not a heart attack. It's an electrical problem that causes the heart to malfunction and suddenly stop beating. This distinction is important because sudden cardiac arrest does not present like a heart attack. Heart attacks are associated with consciousness and chest pain. Sudden cardiac arrest is associated with a sudden loss of consciousness and often not preceded by symptoms. Heart attacks can precede a sudden cardiac arrest in adults, but this is rarely the cause of sudden cardiac arrest in children. Sudden cardiac arrest strikes without warning, leads to death in minutes if the person does not receive immediate help. This can happen to people of all ages who seem healthy, even children and teenagers. Sudden cardiac arrest is the number one killer of Americans and the primary cause of death in young athletes. Immediate treatment includes CPR and the use of an AED or automated external defibrillator. According to the American Heart Association, this treatment should be provided within 3 minutes of collapse to be effective. The longer the delay in beginning CPR and the use of an AED, the greater the likelihood of the loss of life. Even the fastest emergency medical services may not be able to reach a victim this quickly. That is why prompt action by bystanders is so critical and why it is so important to have an AED on site and more lay people trained in the use of the CPR and the AED. The average EMS response time is 6 to 12 minutes. These are statistics related to sudden cardiac arrest. There are over 350,000 sudden cardiac arrests out of hospital. Of these, 7,000 are children younger than 18 years of age. In 90% of the cases, it leads to death. Next slide. These are the causes of sudden cardiac arrest in the young. I'm going to focus on the first one and the last one, but I want you to be aware that there are several congenital heart diseases and genetic issues that can cause sudden cardiac death. Many times these can be diagnosed by a family history or a personal history of chest pain or syncope, which is the fancy medical term for fainting, during exercise. Some of these, however, have absolutely no warning signs or symptoms. One example of this is hypertrophic cardiomyopathy. Hypertrophic cardiomyopathy is the number one reason why athletes die suddenly on the court or in the field. Unfortunately, sudden cardiac arrest is often the first presenting sign that someone has hypertrophic cardiomyopathy. Hypertrophic cardiomyopathy is an abnormal thickening of the left ventricle. The cardiac myocytes, or heart cells, are abnormal and provide substrate for malignant arrhythmias, meaning the cells themselves start the arrhythmia that needs to be cured or hopefully changed to a normal sinus arrhythmia. I shouldn't use the word cure, by the AED. When a child is known to have one of these diagnoses, they can receive treatment and restrictions in athletics to significantly decrease their risk for the life-threatening arrhythmias. I'd also like to focus on the last cause here. This is commotio cordis. This is not technically a disease, but it is an important cause of sudden cardiac arrest in youth. Commotio cordis is the disruption of normal heart rhythm that occurs from a blunt blow to the chest area directly over the heart, such as being hit by a baseball or a hockey puck or even another player. Depending upon where this blunt blow occurs in the cardiac cycle, ventricular fibrillation or malignant arrhythmia can occur, which requires an AED to stop. Signs and symptoms of sudden cardiac arrest include shortness of breath, chest pain, heart palpitations, extreme dizziness, and loss of consciousness. Sudden or unexplained death in family members or heart abnormalities is critical information to know in your family history. This chart illustrates the steps in the chain of survival for a sudden cardiac arrest. First, we need to have early recognition of sudden cardiac arrest. The victim at this point has collapsed and is unresponsive. Sometimes they're not breathing, but at other times they can be making gasping, gurgling, snorting, or moaning sounds. They may even have seizure-like activities. At this point, it is critical to activate the school's emergency response plan. 911 should be called and someone should be sent to fetch the AED. You must begin early CPR after the patient has collapsed with early chest compressions. Please do not be afraid to start chest compressions. It's much better to start chest compressions and have them not needed than not to start them in someone who is not having their heart pump effectively. Once the AED is obtained, it is critical to use it to obtain normal heart rhythm as soon as possible. The AED is extremely easy to use, and I encourage you to go onto the Project Adam website and see how an AED is used. It will literally talk you through exactly what you need to do to save a person's life. Hopefully by this point, EMS has arrived and they can begin advanced life support and transport the patient to the hospital for post-cardiac arrest care and recovery. I encourage you all also to get your CPR certification online. It's easy and inexpensive.
Schools play a key role in the cardiac chain of survival to prevent sudden cardiac death. According to the American Academy of Pediatrics, on average, school-age children spend 28% of their day in school, and 68% of school nurses had to manage a life-threatening emergency requiring EMS activation. Schools are responsible for providing a safe environment for learning and must be prepared for all medical emergencies. Because approximately 20% of a community is in its schools at any given day, including students, teachers, staff, coaches, and family members, a focused effort on cardiac arrest preparedness in schools is critical to protecting our children and community members. New York State education law requires schools to have AEDs and at least one staff person trained in CPR and AED use on site and at all school-sponsored athletic events. In addition, it requires all coaches to be CPR and AED trained. Students are also required to receive instruction for CPR and AED use in order for them to graduate high school. However, the law does not mandate schools to develop a cardiac emergency response plan. Next slide. So, to get to the main question, is your school prepared for a cardiac emergency? To help answer this question, ask yourself some other questions. Is there a cardiac emergency response plan in place? Are AEDs accessible and functional? Is there a cardiac emergency response team in place and identified? And also, is your local EMS and police aware of your school's plan and preparedness? If you've answered no to any of these questions, then we encourage you to contact our Project Adam team to help you, to help your school to become heart safe.
Project Adam was founded in 1999. Project Adam also stands for Automated Defibrillators in Adam's Memory. As you saw in the beginning video, it was created in the memory of Adam Lamel, a young athlete from Wisconsin who died suddenly while playing basketball. An AED was not available. At this point, Project Adam has 33 affiliates in 27 states, reaching schools across the country. Project Adam is responsible for more than 150 lives saved. Maria Fareri Children's Hospital is the New York affiliate for schools and communities in Westchester County, wishing to participate in Project Adam and gain the Heart Safe designation. The mission of Project Adam New York is to protect school-age children from dying from sudden cardiac arrest. Our objective is to educate, give guidance, provide resources to schools and community programs on developing cardiac emergency response plans, including CPR and AED training and access to AEDs.
The Project Adam Heart Safe School designation is attained by schools upon successful implementation of a quality sudden cardiac arrest awareness and preparedness program as outlined by the 14 requirements on this checklist. Based on New York State education laws that Alice touched upon, the hope is that most schools have already reached many of these requirements, or at least the AEDs in the building and staff trained in CPR. Therefore, the focus could be on planning and preparedness for a cardiac emergency in your school. We will send you a follow-up email with the 14-step checklist for you to carefully review, but for now, I'd like to highlight the primary requirements. A cardiac emergency response team must be established with 10% of a school staff who are certified in CPR and AED training. AEDs should be accessible to a victim within a 2 to 3 minute brisk walk from anywhere in the school. Your local EMS could help you assess the best locations to install your AEDs. Prominent signage of AEDs is also important. This way they are easy to find by anyone who is in the school when there is an emergency. Cardiac emergency response plans are essential to ensure that all staff are able to respond quickly and decisively to a cardiac arrest on school grounds. Drills practiced at least once a year with staff and local EMS are also important to keep some staff familiar with AED location and be able to respond rapidly to an on-site emergency. Specific emergency action plans are important to establish for individual students known to be at risk of sudden cardiac arrest based on their medical history. How can we help? I know that 14 steps might sound overwhelming, but for the most part, many schools have already reached some of these requirements. Plus, our team is here to help. Project Adam provides tools and resources for schools to develop their Heart School Safe program. Those tools include cardiac emergency planning templates, resources for CPR training and AED purchases, a reference manual, and one-on-one consultation with our team to help prevent sudden cardiac death in your school. Many of these resources and other educational videos could be found on Project Adams' website. Schools that complete the Project Adams 14-step checklist will obtain the HeartSafe school designation with a certificate and a banner that you can display proudly in your school. So what's next? Decide to become a HeartSafe school. Develop a HeartSafe school leadership team and schedule an appointment with us to get you started. I know that you all might be busy and not have the time to do this now, so we just ask to keep the program in mind, and when you're ready, give us a call. The short video up next is about Claire, a high school volleyball player who collapsed during a volleyball game. She survived because her school was prepared as a result of their HeartSafe school training through a Project Adam affiliate. Claire is Project Adam's 100th save.
But the 100th save was a girl named Claire Crawford. She was playing volleyball. And it's, you know, CPR stories and saves are really interesting to me because it seems that a lot of things have to go right. But it's not really luck, it's more preparedness. And as long as you're prepared to respond in case of an emergency, because it can happen anywhere at any time. And so that's why it's called a sudden cardiac arrest. But she was playing volleyball. She went, and it shows her dad had set up a video. It was senior night. She's the only senior on the team. And they were playing a team that they thought they would play again in the playoffs. So they were going to use it for scouting video as well. He'd set up the tripod, push the play button on the camera, and it captured the entire collapse of sudden cardiac arrest and her rescue.
That's a tough one. In summary, we urge your school to become a HeartSafe school. Sudden cardiac arrest is the number one cause of death in the U.S. We hope we have illustrated that cardiac emergency response plans are essential to preventing sudden cardiac death. We want to thank you, and this concludes the formal part of our presentation. We want to thank the American Heart Association team for their support of our Project Adam New York HeartSafe School program. And thank you all for taking the time today to attend this webinar. We hope that you found it informative. We will send you a follow-up email with a PDF of this presentation and the checklist of the 14 requirements to become a HeartSafe School. Feel free to contact any one of us with any questions, or if you wish to participate, and we'll get you right on your way. Thank you. Are there any questions?
So it doesn't appear that there are any questions. I would love to hear, what is the first step that can be taken to become a HeartSafe school?
So I think the first step is contacting us. I mean, that mm-hmm. I think that's 90% of it right there. Once you contact us, we will work with you and help you, and it will just flow. The Project Adam National Program has so many tools and resources that it'll be a very easy, well-trodden path for us to walk down with you to get your school heart safe certification. Mm-hmm.
like Alice said, we're going to send everybody a hard copy of the 14-step checklist, so then they can really carefully review that and have an understanding of what the requirements are. But we do have all the tools and the resources to help set that up for them and guide them through that process.
Mm-hmm. Well, fantastic. Well, I don't see any questions in the chat box. I think we can encourage anyone who is still logged in to please, follow up mm-hmm. with this team there. I know they're happy to answer any questions that you might have. Do you want to leave us with a closing thought before we end this webinar?
No, I think, I guess, and I don't want to speak out of turn, but I think the idea was also is to present this now at the end of the school year. We know that it's overwhelming, but it's to sort of plant the seed for the fall. And once school gets up and running, is then really hopefully some of you then will reach out to us for the fall. We're available at any time.
Oh, sorry, Alice.
No.
For the last word, I guess I would just say is get CPR certified. That's, that would be really, really wonderful if we could get as many people as possible CPR certified.
Mm-hmm. And everybody be aware of where the AEDs are in their schools and make all the staff and even children aware so everyone can quickly react to a cardiac emergency.
Oh, look, we actually have two questions. We said this the last word, but now we have two questions. So the first one is, they're coming in. Let's see. Who could we attend classes at WCMC?
That's an awesome question. The short answer is yes. The longer answer is I work on it. But absolutely, I think you can definitely, if by classes, I'm assuming you mean CPR. The short answer is yes, but I have to look into all the details about where and when and how. What's interesting is that because of the COVID pandemic, it's been acceptable to get your CPR certification online. And I know that sounds a little crazy that you haven't actually practiced on a mannequin, but I took the online refresher class myself just a couple weeks ago, and I was really impressed at how thorough it was. So you can actually get your CPR certification online. But yes, eventually in the future, we will have classes at the Children's Hospital as well.
Excellent. And one other question is, who should be part of the team?
Does anybody want to? Go ahead, Dana.
No, I was saying, typically, it's the school nurse. And then it really could be any staff in the school, but you probably want staff that's spread out through the school so you have coverage throughout the school. So, and they say, the guideline is 10% of the school staff or at least 5 to 10 people on staff. And, my general suggestion would be spread out throughout the school and maybe the nurse as the head of that just because she has the medical background. Mm-hmm.
All right, well, excellent. Thank you all again. Again, we encourage everyone to please reach out directly if you have any additional questions or want to get involved and learn more. We also encourage everyone in honor of CPR and AED Awareness Week to please visit cpr.heart.org to learn more about the resources that the American Heart Association has available in English and in Spanish. We put the link in the chat box one more time.
And the American Heart Association also has great CPR training materials and courses on their website. I don't know if Megan had posted that as well.
Most definitely. Well, Alice, Dana, Dr. Krista, thank you again for hosting this conversation. It's always a pleasure to collaborate with you and all the phenomenal work that you're doing in Westchester and beyond. Take care, everyone.
Thank you.
All right, thank you.
Bye-bye.